Hi students, this is Alex here. In this video, we are going to discuss a problem based on Euler's theorem on homogeneous function. There is a function z which is x into f of y by x plus g of y by x. Then we have to prove these two expressions. Here we notice that f of y by x is multiplied with x, but here g of y by x alone. So we have to take the first function or first term as u, which is x into f of y by x. In the same way, the second term is v, which is g of y by x. Now u and v both are in terms of x and y, so we will rewrite as u of x comma y, which is nothing but x into f of y by x. In the same way, it is v of x comma y, which is nothing but g of y by x. Now we have to check whether it is a homogeneous function or not. For that, we have to replace x as tx, y as ty. So here it is going to be tx and f of ty by tx. In the same way here, v of tx comma ty, which is nothing but g of ty by tx. We can cancel the t term here and here. After that, in the first one, we left with t and x into f of y by x, which is nothing but u of x comma y. From this, it is clear that the function u is homogeneous with degree 1 because we have t power 1. Similarly, here we are getting back the original function v of x comma y. Sorry. And outside we don't have anything in terms of t, so it is t power 0. So u is a homogeneous function of degree 1. Similarly, v is a homogeneous of degree 0. So already we have taken u and v from the z. So we have z is nothing but u plus v. And if I differentiate this, dou z by dou x, it is nothing but dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y. In the same way, if I differentiate partial differentiation with respect to y, we give dou z by dou y equal to dou u by dou y plus dou v by, sorry, this first term is with respect to x, dou v by dou y. So we have taken this as 1 and we have partially differentiated with respect to x and with respect to y. Since we found u and v are the homogeneous function of degree 1 and 0, by Euler's theorem, we can say x into dou u by dou x plus y into dou u by dou y equal to nu. In the same way, if we write for v, it will become x into dou v by dou x plus y into dou v by dou y equal to n v. But here n is 1, here n is 0. So this will become x into dou u by dou x plus y into dou u by dou y equal to 1 u. And on the other side, it is x into dou v by dou x plus y into dou v by dou y equal to 0 into v, which is 0. We have replaced the value of n from the degree of u and degree of v in these two places. Let's name this expression as fourth and this expression as fifth. Now we are going to add 4 and 5. So fourth expression and fifth expression both are added together. So x into dou u by dou x plus y into dou u by dou y plus x into dou v by dou x plus y into dou v by dou y equal to other side we have u and other side we have 0. So totally it is u. Now we will group together these two terms. We can take x common. By taking x common, we left with dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou x. In the same way, from these two, we can take y common. So y into dou u by dou y plus dou v by dou y equal to u. But u is nothing but originally we have taken x into f of y by x. So we will replace it here, which is x into f of y by x. Now let's see the expression 2 and 3. Dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou x. We have dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou x. So this can be replaced from the expression 2. From the expression 2, it is dou z by dou x. In the same way, this dou u by dou y plus dou v by dou y can be replaced from the expression 3 as dou z by dou y. So from 2 and 3, we are going to substitute this. So substituting from 2 and 3, outside there is x, this is dou z by dou x, then outside there is y, then dou z by dou y equal to x into f of y by x. So we got the first proof, x into dou z by dou x plus y into dou z by dou y equal to x into f of y by x. So first subdivision we proved. For proving the second part of the question, once again we are going to use the Euler's theorem. Here we found the function u and v are the homogeneous function of degree 1 and 0 respectively, and by Euler's theorem we got this fourth and fifth statement. In the same way, once again we are going to write by Euler's theorem. Let's write for separately u, that is x square into dou square u by dou x square plus 2xy into dou square u by dou x dou y plus y square into dou square u by dou y square equal to n into n minus 1 into u. Since the value of n is 1, by replacing here, this entire term will become 0 into u. So it is 0. So what we got is, this entire expression is 0. Already we have 5 expressions. So let's take this as the 6th one. In the same way, we'll write for v, that is x square into dou square v by dou x square plus 2xy into dou square v by dou x dou y plus y square into dou square v by dou y square equal to n into n minus 1 into v, and here the value of n is 0. So this entire term will become 0 once again. So let's rewrite this equal to 0. Let's take this as the 7th expression. Now we are going to add 6 and 7. So adding 6 and 7, while adding itself, I take the similar terms, grouping together and taking common, that is these two terms having x square common. So first I will write x square, then I will write the sum of the terms. So x square into dou square u by dou x square plus dou square v by dou x square. Then from the second term, in both the expression, we can take 2xy common. Taking 2xy common, we get 2xy open bracket dou square u by dou x dou y plus dou square v by dou x dou y plus in the last term, once again, y square is common. So in both the term, when y square is taken common, we left with y square into dou square u by dou x square, sorry, dou square u by dou y square plus dou square v by dou y square. And on the other side, both the expression has zero. Now, from the term z, when I differentiate partially with respect to x, we already got the second and third. Once again, if I differentiate, I will get the second order here. So, I will directly replace. The first term is x square into, this is going to be dou square z by dou x square because z is u plus v. So, when I differentiate twice, we get this expression. In the same way, 2xy, this is dou square z by dou x dou y. And the last term is y square into dou square z by dou y square, which is equal to 0. So, let's check the question. The second statement which you have to prove is x square into dou square z by dou x square. Plus 2xy dou square z by dou xy, then plus y square into dou square z by dou y square equal to 0, which we got it here. So, once again, we use the Euler's theorem for getting this proof.